Pastor Trish and Thursday evening devotions for us. And this evening we have traveled to Psalm 76. There are times when I come across the psalm and frankly, I don't like it. It doesn't seem to resonate in me, or I just find it difficult to understand or imagine or whatever that might be. And Psalm 76, I would say, is one of those psalms. It's kind of like, so what? But as I've wrestled with it for a while, I've come to find some fruitfulness in it. And I think that that's one of the disciplines and joys and perhaps rewards of simply spending time letting scripture resonate in us and spending time with it. Even if it's something that maybe is a little unfamiliar to us, it's not one of our favorite verses or those kinds of things, it can still end up speaking to us. And so let's see what Psalm 76 does for us this evening. It is a psalm of victory. And keep in mind that we are in these psalms. Psalm 73 to 83 are these songs of Asaph, and probably were parts of liturgy, were meant to be, were sung, not just meant to be sung, but were sung. And I'm telling you that because I'm going to come back to that a little bit. So a song of victory that talks about God's victory and uses a lot of, the reason it didn't sit well with me initially is it's probably got a lot of warrior language and military language. But as one of the commentaries reminded me, there's truth telling in that. Because unfortunately, we live in a world where there's always war and violence and difficulty going on. She had said, we've almost never lived as tolerant and peaceful people. The commentator here is Beth Tanner. She says, my mother is 85 years old, and in her lifetime, this country, the United States, has engaged in 6 wars, justified or not, and thousands upon thousands have died. This psalm praises the human war machinery, but praises God's ability to bring war to an end. It declares that God is stronger than the most fierce of human fighters and announces that God judges not by some arbitrary moral scale, but will lift up the poor of the land. In other words, nothing could be further from the modern war strategy than what is declared in this poem. And so I listen and I listen again and strain to hear those words. So let me read Psalm 76. God is known in Judah. His name is great in Israel. His dwelling place became Salem. His habitation was Zion. It was there that he broke the fiery shafts of the bow, the shield, the sword, even the battle itself. You are ablaze with light, mightier than the mountains that give food. The brave-hearted lie plundered. They sank into deep lethargy. All the strong troops couldn't even lift their hands. At your rebuke, Jacob's God, both chariot and horse were stopped dead still. You are awesome. Who can stand before you when you are angry? You have announced judgment from heaven. The earth grew afraid and fell silent when God rose up to establish justice, when God rose up to save all of the earth's poor. Even human rage will turn to your praise when you dress yourself with whatever remains of your wrath. Make promises to the Lord your God and keep them. Let all around him bring gifts to the awesome one. He breaks the spirit of princes. He is terrifying to all the kings of the earth. I also began to think about how that language is language that really isn't so foreign to us. As the commentator had said, there we are a people used to war, unfortunately, and violence and terror and those kinds of things. But then I also started to think about, and this is where I'm going to come back to, that this was a psalm that was sung. And I began to think about some of our own hymns that we sing, and we still kind of carry on that imagery of God as a warrior, certainly God as a king. I had pulled out our hymnal and found just some of the different hymns that we have. All hail the power of Jesus' name, blessing, honor, and glory. Christ is the king. Crown him with many crowns. Jesus shall reign. Rejoice, for Christ is king. The king shall come. Glorious things of thee are spoken. And so I was like, whoa, wait a minute. I shouldn't be so quick to judge a psalm that may be unfamiliar to me, when perhaps on Sundays I'm often singing psalms with similar kind of imagery. And when I went to some of those hymns or our modern day psalms, and you start to read, in many cases we are describing God as that mighty warrior who has overcome, who has maybe not done battle so much, but certainly won the difficulties, has overcome evil and those kinds of things. And so I wanted to end this evening with, I would call it, a modern day psalm that speaks to me, that I think does a little bit of that as well. It's a prayer that was written by Archbishop Desmond Tutu. And in our hymnal in the ELCA, it was set to music as well by John Bell, who is a Scottish poet, theologian, songwriter. And it's, goodness is stronger than evil. And the prayer goes like this: goodness is stronger than evil. Love is stronger than hate. Light is stronger than darkness. Life is stronger than death. Victory is ours. Victory is ours for God who loves us. Victory is ours. Victory is ours for God who loves us. Amen. It's that reminder of victory. We can look at that in a lot of different ways, but ultimately our victory lies in God, and in particular, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. So have a good evening. We will be back together again next Monday.